Welcome students, welcome to the number system session 3 of class 9 mathematics. We have in the earlier classes we have learned about the decimal expansion of real numbers. Just we will recollect what are the decimal expansions of real numbers. Decimal expansion of real numbers. Decimal expansion of real numbers, we have studied that there are two types of decimal expansions, right? One is terminating decimal expansion, and another one is non-terminating decimal expansion, non-terminating decimal expansion. And in non-terminating decimal expansion, we have learned that there are again two types. Which are those? One is recurring decimal expansion, another one is non-recurring decimal expansion. Recurring decimal expansion, and another one is non-recurring decimal expansion, right? Now, if a real number is terminating, then I can say it is a rational number, right? Then, if a real number is non-terminating and it is having recurring decimal expansion, then also we can say that it is a rational number, right? So real number, if it is the decimal expansion of the real number is terminating, then it is rational number. If it is non-terminating and recurring, it is then also a rational number. If a real number is non-terminating and non-recurring, then you say that number is irrational number, right? This is what we have learned. This is another way of defining rational numbers. Usually how we were defining rational numbers were that rational number, any number can be, if it is written in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q not equal to 0, then it is a rational number. An irrational number not in the form of p by q, right? This is how we are defining. This is another way of defining. What it is, if the decimal expansion of a number is terminating, it is a rational number. If it is non-terminating and recurring, then it is also a rational number. And if the decimal expansion of a real number is non-terminating and non-recurring, then it is irrational, right? This is what we have learned in the previous class. Now, and we have also learned to represent the irrational numbers on the number line. We will just recollect how we have done that. Okay, that is representing irrational numbers on the number line. Suppose we have learned it, just we will recollect once again. Suppose I want to represent root 2 on the number line. So, how to do this root 2 on the number line we have done? That first we are drawing a number line, marking it as here 0. Then we are taking 1 unit from 0, say that is 4, this 4 to A is 1 unit, and from A you have drawn 1 unit perpendicular line, this is also 1 unit, then this marking it as B, then you have joined O to B and this you have marked it as root 2. Fine? Correct. See, why we have taken here it as 1 unit and 1 unit, right? There is a way of doing it. See, root 2 when it is, this 2, we are going to split it in such a way, that is we are going to break up this 2 in such a way as the sum of 2 perfect square numbers. We will break up this 2 as the sum of 2 perfect square numbers. Like this, for 2 it is 1 square plus 1 square. Then I can use this 1 unit here, 1 unit I have got root 2, right? Similarly, if we want to represent root 5, okay, so what we will do, we will split up this 5 as the sum of two perfect square numbers. How to split up this 5? It is 2 square plus 1 square, we can write it. 2 square is 4, 4 plus 1, I am getting it as 5, okay. With this idea, again if you want to represent root 17, suppose I say. Now 17, can we split up this 17 or break up this 17 as the sum of two perfect square numbers? Yes. What are those? It will be perfect square number 16 and 1. Both are perfect square number. 16 plus 1 gives you 17. So 16 is nothing but 4 square and 1 square. Right. Now, this root 5, if we want to represent root 5 on the number line, then you can draw the number line, mark here, first point, mark it here as O. Then take 2 units. It is 2 square plus 1 square. Either I can take 2 plus 1. 2 square plus 1 square will lead you to root 5 or 5. And 1 square plus 2 square also will lead you to 5. So any one way I can take it. So this is, I am marking it as O. Then from O to some point A I will take. This I am taking it as 2 units. 2 units. 2 units. Okay. Then on this 2 units, at this point A, we will draw a perpendicular of 1 unit. Draw a perpendicular of 1 unit. Okay, this is 1 unit. Say this point is B. Then join O to B. This gives you root 5. How? Just see, perpendicular I have said. Well, this is 90 degrees. So consider a right triangle OAB. In right triangle, OAB, hypotenuse square, that is OB square is equal to OA square plus AB square, right? So what is OA? OA is 2 units, so 2 square plus AB is 1 square, that is 4 plus 1, it is 5. OB square is 5, which implies OB is equal to root 5. So this is root 5. This is one way of doing it. Right? Now, so root 5, 5 you can split it as 2 square plus 1 square, you could do. Then 17 also, if you take it as, it can be split as 4 square plus 1 square. So 17 also representing, how you can do that, root 17 on the number line. That is, you will mark a point O here and mark a point A such that 0, O to A will be of 4 units. Then 1 unit perpendicular here, then you are joining. This is the easier way. Now, then you may be having a doubt. Then how to split up this 3? Isn't it? 3. Suppose I want to represent root 3 on the number line. Now this 3, how can we split it up as the sum of the two perfect square numbers? We can't do that. But if you take this 3, it is 1 plus 2. 1 square, it is. Now, what about 2? 2, I get 2 square. When we will get 2, it is square root of 2 if I take. The square of square root of 2, then I will get it as 2 itself. Then square root of 2 plus 1 will be of root 3. Right? So, how will you represent that? For representing that root 3 on the number line, basic thing we have to do is, you have to represent root 2 on the number line first. Root 2 on the number line. Okay, so this is how we have represented root 2 on the number line. Then on this O to B distance is root 2 units. Now you are taking the compass, taking the radius as OB, keeping the center of the the pointer of your compass at O. Then you are drawing an arc. So this point on the number line represents root 2. Agree? That means I mark this point as C. O to C gives you root 2 units. Okay. On this root 2, this unit I wrote here. This is C. This C gives you root 2. On this C, you are drawing a perpendicular of 1 unit. Okay. Now this point I am marking it as say D. Right. This is one unit perpendicular of one. Then this point is D. Then D to O I will join. D to O. Look carefully. D to O. What I have done for root 3? First we have broken this, or we have splitted this 3 as the sum of two perfect squares. That is 1 square and root 2 whole square. Root 2 whole square. Okay. Because root 2 into root 2 gives you 2. Okay. Root 2 whole square. Now, first what we have done to represent this 3 on the number line. First we have to represent root 2. Root 2 normal method we know to represent it. We have represented on the number line. So this C on the number line represents root 2. After this, at C, you are drawing a perpendicular, of one unit. Say at this one unit, D to C is one unit. Okay? You are one unit. Then from O to D you are joining it. Okay. Now consider this triangle. Triangle OCD is a right triangle. In right triangle OCD, OD square is equal to OC square plus CD square. Now how much is OC? OC is root 2 whole square and CD is 1 square. And this is what? Root 2 whole square is nothing but 2. 2 plus 1. 2 plus 1 is 3. So OD square is 3, which implies OD is equal to root 3. So this distance O to D is root 3. Okay, followed. Now on the number line it should be. So with the help of the compass, draw an arc with the radius OD. So this point, say this point is P. This point P gives you root 3. Okay. This is another way of representing it. Now root 3. This is the root 3 point. Now if I draw a one unit perpendicular length here. One unit perpendicular length here. Say this point is E. Okay. This is one unit. And I will join O to E. What do I get? OE. What will be the distance? That distance will be root 4. Then again, I'll take the arc, then I will draw this again. So this is root 4. Root 4 is nothing but 2. Then again, at this point if I draw one unit perpendicular length, say this is at F, then join O to F. How much value do I get? I will get root 5. So this is another way of representing irrational numbers on the number line. Clear? One way, the normal method what we have taught in the session 2 was the spiral method. That way also we can do, or even we can adopt this method also to show the irrational numbers on the number line. Is it okay? And now we will move on to the next topic, that is representing real numbers on the number line. Representing real numbers on the number line. Okay, representing real numbers on the number line. Irrational numbers you have learned. Now in real numbers, suppose we have a number which is whose decimal expansion is terminating. For example, 4.675. This is the number. This number has to be represented on the number line. Okay. Now for this, 4.675 lies between which two numbers? It lies between 4 and 5. Correct? So, let's first represent 4 and 5 on the number line. So, we'll draw a number line. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. It goes on. This side also you can. Equal spacing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here it is minus 1, so on. So 4.675 lies between 4 and 5. lies between 4 and 5. Right? Now, this between 4 and 5, we will magnify this 4 and 5 on the number line by dividing it into 10 equal parts. Okay? So, this number line, we'll magnify this number line between 4 and 5. We'll divide it into 10 equal parts. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Further, 10. Okay, maybe this is 5. Now just mark what is magnification. If this first point is 4.1, 4.2, 4.3, 4.4, 4.5, 4.6, 4.7, 4.8, 4.9 and 5. Now look at this number again. 4.675. So 4.675 lies between 4.6 and 4.7. Correct? It lies between these two numbers. Right? 4.675. So again, this 4.6 and 4.7, we will magnify those two numbers by dividing them into, or the, by dividing those the space between those two numbers into 10 equal parts. We will magnify that. Okay. So next will be, this is 4.6. Then again 10 equal parts, I have said 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Mark it. It is 4.61, 4.62, 4.63, 64, then 4.65, 4.66, 4.67, 4.68, 4.69, and this is what it is, 4.70. Correct? Now, again, 4.6. Now, till here, up to one decimal place, we have come closer to that. Now, the second, 4.675 lies between 4.67 and 4.68. Correct? It's between these two. Now, again, these two numbers, between these two numbers, we will do the magnification. That means, again, we will divide it into 10 equal parts. Okay, so this one I'll take, this is 4.67. 10 divisions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Mark them. It is 4.671. I'll write it here one top so that it will be neatly seen to you. 4.7672. This is 4.673, this one 4.674, 4.675, 4.676, 4.677, 4.678, correct? This is 4.679 and this is 4.6, how much? 6? 8. Correct? Okay. 6, 8, 0 if you want to say. Right. Now, see this. Where it is? 4.675. Again, where it will lie? 6, 7, 5. 4.675. You got it? This point. This is your point. 4.675 on the number line. This is how you are magnifying the number between which it lies and you are able to locate it. This process is known as successive magnification. This is how you are visualizing the real numbers on the number line. This is one type of number line, one type of number, that is, which is terminating and you are representing it. Okay. There are numbers which are non-terminating and repeating also. Those numbers also, in the same way, we can represent them. Okay? What are those? suppose now if I consider the number, this is what it is, the decimal expansion which is terminated, and we have represented in this way. Now we will move on to other type of numbers where the decimal expansion is non-terminating but it is repeating. Okay, that is like, for example, we will take the number 6.47 bar, and they are asking you to represent this on the number line up to 4 decimal places. Then this number will be what? It is 6.4777. Till here you have to represent it on the number line. So beginning to start with, what we will do, we will just see whether this 6.4777 lies between which two numbers. Definitely it will lie between 6 and 7. So we will locate 6 and 7 on the number line first. Locating 6 and 7 on the number line. So this is, if you are taking 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, now 6 and 7. We will mark it here, it lies. This 6.4777 lies between 6 and 7. So we will magnify this numbers. 6 and 7. How to magnify that? We will divide the space between them into 10 equal parts to magnify it. Okay, so this is 6. Then 10 divisions you will take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Marking we will do it as 6.1, 6.2, 6.3, 6.4, 6.5, 6.6, 7, 6.8, 6.9, and 7. Correct? Then 6.4777. So it is between 6.4 and 6.5. Correct? No? 6.4 and 6.5. The number lies here now. We have come little closer to that, closer to this number. 6 to 7 range it was, now it is between 6.4 and 6.5. now we will magnify this again. Magnifying it is here, it is 6.4. then 10 divisions we will make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Equal divisions with the help of your scale you will have to draw it. This is 6.41, 6.42, 6.43, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6, 6.47, 6.48, 6.49, and this is 6.56. Correct? Now, again, still closer it has come. Where it has come now, you see, 6.4777. So it is between 6.47 and 6.48, between these two numbers. Correct? No? Again, this we will do the magnification of that. Okay. Now it is at 6.47 and 6.48, we will do the magnification. So 10 divisions again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so this is what it is: 6.471, 6.472, then 6.4773, 6.4742, then 6.475, 6.476, 6.477, 6.478, 6.479, and this is 6.480. Correct? Still closer we have come up. It is, we have reached up to 6.477, one more decimal point. That means the number lies between these two, 6.477 and 6.478. So one more time, magnification we have to do, right? So since if I go down, you will not be able to see that. So this portion I will draw. This here I will do it. Just look at that magnification. The number I will write it down here. It is 6.477 we have to represent. Okay, this is your first magnification. Second, third, fourth, and fifth I will do it here. Okay, fifth one, where it has to be from 6.477 to 6.478, that magnification we have to do. So again, 10 equal divisions we will make. So I'll start with 6.477. So 10 divisions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay? So see, this is how much? 6.477. So 770 it is right now. So 6.4771, 6.4772, 6.4773, 6.4774. Be careful while writing the numbers. 4775. Then this is 6.4776, 6.4777. This is 6.4778, 6.4779. This is how much? 6.4780. Correct. Now look your number. It is 6.4777. Have you got it? Yes. This represents your number 6.4777 on the number line. How many magnifications you have done? 5. Because they have told you to represent up to 4 decimal points. It depends upon how much they will be telling it. This is the way of representing real numbers on the number line. Here what we have learned, just recollect, we have represented 2 types of numbers on the number line. One was the number which had terminating decimal expansion. Another number was what? It is non-terminating, but it was repeating. So these 2 numbers we have represented on the number line. Okay. Now with this, we will try to solve the exercise questions. Well, that is exercise 1.4. So looking at this exercise 1.4. Okay, there are 2 questions in that. First one, we will see. Visualize 3.765 on the number line using successive magnification. 3.765 on the number line. So 3.765 lies between 3 and 4. So first we will mark that 3 and 4 on the number line. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the number lies between 3 and 4. So this we will magnify, this one. 3 and 4. So between 3 and 4 we will make it into 10 small divisions. This is 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, so this is 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, 3.4. Equal divisions you make with the help of your scale. 3.8, 3.9, and 4. Right? Now, again, look at 3.765. So, we have come to the first decimal place. It is 3.7 here. So, the next one, 3.765. So, that 3.765 will lie between 3.7 and 3.8. So, that again, that magnification. This is 3.7 for the second decimal place, okay? 10 divisions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is 3.71, 3.72, 3.73, writing like this, one up, one down, so that you can, you'll be able to write the numbers. Otherwise, if you write in a straight line, all congested it becomes. That is why there is no other purpose of that. 3.76, 3.77, 3.78, 3.79, and this is 3.80. Right? So to the second decimal place we have come closer to. 3.76. 3.76 is there. So next number is 5. So it lies between 3.76 and 3.77. Correct? So we will draw that again. We will magnify that portion. Magnify portion 3.76 to 3.77 by dividing it into 10 equal parts. So this is 3.76. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this number, maybe it is 3.76, 1, 3.76, 2, 3.76, 3, 3.76, 4, 3.76, 5, 3.76, 6, this is 7, 6, 7, 3.76, 8, 3.76, 9, and this is 3.770. Correct? Now look at, have you got it? Third decimal place? Yes. 3.765. So this is your number, the number line. How many magnifications? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? This is the number 3.765 on the number line. Okay? We'll go to the next one. Is this clear? Mark it carefully. Once you do, you'll be able to get that. Okay? So moving to the next one. Moving to the second question. They have said, visualize 4.26 bar on the number line up to 4 decimal places. Up to 4 decimal places. That means we have to do it up to 4.2626. Right? So 4.2626 lies between 4 and 5 as usual first step. So represent that on the number line. Which one? 4 and 5. Correct. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this 4 and 5 to be magnified. So magnifying this portion of 4 and 5 by dividing it into 10 equal parts. So this is 4, 10 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I'll extend this 9 and 10. Okay. So 4.1, 4.2, 4.3, 4.4. 5. Correct? Now first decimal place 4.2. So it will lie between 4.2 and 4.3. This portion to be magnified. This arrow I am drawing should, so that it looks like a lens. That's it. Nothing else. We are magnifying it. Magnifying 4.2 and 4.3. So this number will take it as 4.2. So 10 divisions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I'll put it here 4.21, 4.22, 4.23, 4.24, 4.25, 4.26, 4.27, 4.28, 4.29, and 4.30. Correct. So the second decimal place now, 4.26, yes, it has come here, 4.26. So it will lie between 4.26 and 4.27. So again, next step, we have to magnify, magnifying this again. So what it is, 4.26, from there to 4.27, we have to magnify. So again, 10 divisions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, so this is 4.27, 4.6, 6 is there, no? 4.26 is there. So 4.26 1, 4.26 2, 4.26 3, 4.26 4, 26 5, 4.26 6, this is 4.26 7, 4.26 8, 4.26 9, 4.270. Correct? This one. Now, to the third decimal place, we have to see it is 2, 4.262. 4.261, 4.262 we have got. So, it lies between these two. So, one more magnification. Correct? So, if I write it here below, then you will not be able to see it. So, I will put it here on the top. Was the number what we were to represent was 4.2626, correct? No, so this is first magnification, second, third, fourth, the fifth one I will do it here where it is 4.262 to 4.263. So here 4.262 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10. So this number next, this number will be 4.2621, 4.2622, 4.2623. Be careful while writing. 2624, then 4.2625, 4.262626. This is 4.2627. 4.2628, 4.2629, 4.2630. Correct? Right? Now, did we get the fourth decimal place number? Where is that? Here, 4.2626. So, this is here, 4.2626. With this, we complete the exercise and we have learned the representation of the decimal expansions of the numbers on the number line. That two types of decimal expansions. One was terminating and another one is it is non-terminating but repeating decimal expansion. Okay, with this we will come to the end of exercise 1.4. Okay, thank you.